Chanting power to the people, protesters called for a return to full civilian rule, but military forces again responded with force, leaving two people dead. Prime Minister Hamdok's decision to quit leaves the army in full control. It's another blow to Sudan's fragile attempts at a transition to democratic rule after a popular uprising led to the overthrow of Sudan's long-term authoritarian president Omar al-Bashir in 2019. In the televised address, Hamdok said the country was at a dangerous turning point that threatens its whole survival.
I have tried my best to stop the country from sliding towards disaster. Sudan is crossing now a dangerous turning point that threatens its whole survival.
Civilian and military leaders had made an easy power-sharing agreement after the army staged a coup on 25th October and initially placed Prime Minister under house arrest. The country was just 1 month away from transition to a civilian head of state when the army seized power. Hamdok, an economist by training, is widely respected in the international community, having previously worked as an official with the United Nations. He helped negotiate a deal to forgive some of Sudan's debts, but this involved removing fuel subsidies, leading the prices of many basic goods to rise, and to anti-government protests. Under the arrangement reached with Hamdok in November, the restated prime minister was supposed to lead a cabinet of technocrats until elections were held. But it was unclear how much power the new civilian government would have, and protests against the military resumed, which were often violently suppressed. More than 50 people have been killed during protests since the coup, including at least two on Sunday, according to the pro-democracy Sudan Central Doctors Committee. Thousands of people were on the streets of capital Khartoum and the city of Omdurman on Sunday, chanting and calling on the military to leave politics. On social media, activists have said 2022 will be the year of the continuation of resistance. Coup leader General Abdel Fattah al-Burhan has defended last October's coup, saying the army had acted to prevent a civil war. He says Sudan is still committed to the transition to civilian rule with elections planned for July 2023. The resignation of Prime Minister Hamdok is a big blow to the military leaders who had thought an agreement with Hamdok would appease protesters and legitimize their stay in power. The current political crisis now threatens to return Sudan to the authoritarian years of former ousted leader Omar al-Bashir.